Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.2, Problem 7. This is Section 6.2, Problem number 7. It says, Dirty Dean tells dirty jokes that occasionally contain an F-bomb. The probability that one of Dirty Dean's jokes has an F-bomb is 30%. Use the binomial probability chart to determine the probability that in the next four jokes, Dean will use the F-bomb only once, at least once, at most once, in all four jokes and in none of the jokes. So to start this off, we need to look in the chart, find the section of the chart where we have N is 4, the possible values for X will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we want, there's many columns for this. We want to find the column that says 0.30, because that's the one we'd want for 30%. And I do have these numbers already written down. So next to 0, we will have 0.240. Next to 1 is 0.412. Next to 2 is 0.265. Next to 3 is 0.076, and next to 4 is 0.008. So now, using this information, what's the probability that the F-bomb shows up in a joke only once? So we want to do for once, we go to the part of the chart for 1, and the probability is 0.412. So it's about a 41% probability. Now, at least once means once is the least. It's one joke or more. So that would be the probability for 1 plus the probability for 2 plus the probability for 3 plus the probability for all 4. So for 1 from our chart is 0.412. For 2, from the chart, we have 0.265. For 3, the chart tells us 0.076. And for 4 is 0.008. And if you add all that up, it adds up to 0.761. By adding 0.412 plus 0.265 plus 0.076 plus 0.008. Now, what you might notice is basically we added all the numbers except the one next to the 0. We added 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in theory, you should be able to do 1 minus the value for 0 and get the same answer. 1 minus 0.240 is 0.760, so it's pretty close. The reason for that is there's some round off. These numbers are generated from using the formula for binomial probability, that n combination x times p to the x times 1 minus p to the n minus x. And they're just rounding the answers they're getting to three places after the decimal. That's why there's a little bit of a difference. It's actually easier to just do 1 minus the only one that you didn't include, because that second column should add up to a total of 1. But this is a little bit more straightforward way. It's a little bit of a shortcut to do 1 minus the only one that's not in your list. But anyway, on to the next one. What's the probability that the F-bomb appears in a joke at most once? But at most one, but at most once. So it'd be one time is the most. So it'd be probability of just one plus probability of none of the jokes, which could happen. So for one is 0.412 from my work with the chart. And then for 0 is 0.240. And now you would add 0.412 plus 0.240. So even without looking on my paper, I can see it's 0.652. About a 65% probability. Now, what's the probability that the F-bomb shows up in all four of the jokes, 4 out of 4? So you would go to 4.008. So a little less than 1% probability, almost 1%. And in none of the jokes, well, none of the jokes would mean 0 jokes. So go to where x, number of successes is 0. Next to that is 0.240, which is a 24% probability.